I remained on the payroll, so to speak, at Fox Chase during all this stuff. I very often didn't get a salary, but you know, I was still kind of part time, and I maintained my office, and I was back here, you know, quite often. So I've had this since 1964. You know, I've been on the, been paying Social Security and so forth through Fox Chase. Well, when I came back again, I got sort of, I was sort of restless for a while. I thought it would be unwise to try to start the laboratory up again. Part of it was practical, you know, when you're, what, 80 or something, or late 70s, you don't want to have young scientists come and work with you. That's not very good prospects, you know, for their career. And starting up a whole new lab. And in a way, I mean, I was sort of tempted to apply for grants, but one of them was, if I didn't get the grant, I'd be disappointed. And then if I got the grant, I'd say, well, I'm being competitive with these young scientists who, you know, the money was getting scarce. So on balance, I didn't think it was a good thing. And I think you sort of, after a while, scientists may kind of taper down, so to speak. I mean, I feel I still have a lot of new ideas and fresh approaches, but it's probably best exerted by, you know, well, talking to people, you know, and telling them about it in the hope that some of the ideas are good enough so somebody will do them, you know. And you never know, you know, sometimes you give a lecture and I told you the story about the gender ratio. Now, that's already read the book by chance. Well, you never quite know that's going to happen. But I feel I do have an obligation, you know, to talk about it.